I'm an engineer at Facebook, and I'm here to talk about a project at Facebook to improve performance of React Native infrastructure. User experience on mobile benefits from three primary metrics. Time to interaction, which is the amount of time between when you actually launch the app or when you start bringing out a surface, and when people can actually interact with that and use it usefully. The App Store download size, on Android that's the APK size, which is just the size of the artifact that you download from the Play Store. And memory utilization, which is the amount of memory your application consumes while running on the device, which has to be shared with all the other applications and infrastructure running on the phone. So what can you do to improve these metrics? As React Native developers, you're all familiar with the ways React Native uses JavaScript. Your code manipulates state and props, you return rendered components, and you have all of your other business logic. But you might not be familiar with the way React Native works under the hood. So let me talk about that for a little bit. In the Android app, messages pass from Java Native modules across the C++ bridge to a JavaScript engine, sometimes called a JavaScript virtual machine or a VM. Messages can also pass in the other direction. This JavaScript engine is actually what executes the JavaScript code if you like. And the primary metrics are significantly affected by the startup performance of that JavaScript engine. Which brings me to the real topic of my talk. So let's bring up the title slide again. I'm here to talk today about Facebook's Hermes JavaScript community. So what is Hermes? Hermes is a new JavaScript engine designed for the mobile environment, focusing on startup performance. Application code generally requires no changes to work with Hermes. All the changes are within the React Native infrastructure. Hermes is in production today. Most of Facebook's React Native products on Android are already powered by Hermes. This includes our biggest React Native app, Marketplace, and other apps such as Crisis Response and the Oculus Companion app. We've seen significant performance benefits, which have justified investing in a team dedicated to this work. I'll share some numbers later, but let's start off with a quick video demo. Mattermost is a real-world, open-source React Native app. We compiled it with Hermes on the left and with the 0.60.1 React Native release on the right, running on a Google Pixel phone. Remember, this is a phone which came out in 2016. Phones have gotten much better in the last few years. You can see the app using Hermes is ready to use more than 2 seconds sooner. This is consistent with the TTI metric I discussed before. So I went over these metrics earlier. Let me review them. So TTI, time to interaction, is the amount of time between when you start the app or launch a surface and you can actually start using it. App size, or APK size, which is the size of the binary that people fetch from the App Store over Wi-Fi or in a lot of places over a carrier network. And memory, which is how much shared resources on your phone that you use. So here are the measurements for the metrics for the Mattermost startup demo you just saw. You can see the TTI difference reflected in the video. These numbers are a little bit different than what was actually in the video because the video takes into account things that the Android platform does before we can actually do our own measurement traces. But the difference is about the same. You can see that memory utilization is down by about a quarter, which makes you a better citizen on the phone, less likely to have other issues. And the APK size has dropped by nearly half. Hermes is much smaller than other VMs. Our build includes ARM and x86 for both 32 and 64 bits, so the overall app size is bigger than some of your applications. Maybe bigger than some of your applications, but you can always package things separately if you want. In Facebook apps, this improvement in metrics has led to more downloads and fewer out-of-memory errors. You might be wondering why I used an older device like this for our demo. We're focused on mobile. Focusing on mobile devices means focusing on devices people have. As developers, we tend to carry the latest flagship devices. Most users around the world don't. Commonly used Android devices have less memory and less storage than newest phones, and much less than a desktop or laptop. This is especially true outside of the United States. Mobile flash is also relatively slow, leading to high I/O latency. In the next section of the talk, I'll explain how the Hermes focus on these device characteristics benefits the primary metrics. But But first, we're proud to announce we're open sourcing Hermes today on GitHub. We're also open sourcing Hermes integration with React Native, so developers can opt into using Hermes immediately. At the end of the talk, I'll give some links which explain how you can do this. So a couple other background about Hermes. Hermes implements the JavaScript language, but the mobile apps that we have in mind when building Hermes are really different than other common JavaScript use cases. We're not trying to compete in the web browser space or in the server space. Hermes could in theory be used for those kinds of use cases, but that's never been our goal. Now let's talk a little bit about some of the design decisions we made and the trade-offs they represent. Earlier, I said the JavaScript engine is what executes your JavaScript code. This is actually a multi-step pipeline. Some of you may be familiar with this, but I'll talk through it a little bit. So Babel takes the code that you actually write and converts it into compliant JavaScript code. So for example, if you have XJS representing part of your user interface, Babel will translate that into JavaScript calls that create those underlying objects for the engine and for the React Native infrastructure to use. Once you have the JavaScript code, Minify just shrinks it, so your apps can be a little bit smaller. And then once you're done with that, you package it up in your APK and you upload it to the Play Store. When the user downloads the app and then runs the app, then the JavaScript engine, JavaScript engine loads that, parses the code, compiles it into an intermediate form that can be interpreted, and then finally executes it. With Hermes, instead of needing to parse and compile the JavaScript on device while the user is waiting, we can move that work to build time. By running the compiler at build time and incorporating the bytecode in the APK sent to the Play Store, we can reduce the size of the application. Now, when the user runs the app, the execution can begin immediately, reducing time to interaction to just the execution time of your JavaScript code. Ahead of time compilation also lets us do more complex, time-consuming optimizations and whole program optimizations. For example, we can look for identical functions throughout your program and deduplicate them. We can also take the strings from all of your JavaScript code, pack them together into an efficient storage form that actually has no runtime overhead to access. Flash memory I/O also adds significant latency on many medium and low-end mobile devices. With Hermes, bytecode can be memory mapped and loaded from flash incrementally as needed. Because flash is often so slow, optimizing bytecode for size can lead to significant TTI improvements. Because the memory is mapped read-only and backed by a file, mobile operating systems that don't swap, such as Android, can still evict these pages under memory pressure. This reduces auto-process kills on memory-constrained devices and can help you work better in the background. Bytecode is also smaller than JS, and our experience with Facebook apps about one-third smaller than minified JS. If you aren't familiar with a just-in-time compiler, or a JIT, let me explain what that is. An engine can measure which parts of the JavaScript code are commonly used, and then compile them to machine code to increase execution speed. Unlike the most commonly used engines today, Hermes has not implemented JIT. JITs improve common compute-heavy benchmarks, such as PDF rendering, but these benchmarks are not representative of mobile app workloads. We've measured that most functions in our React Native app bundles are executed 0 or 1 times during TTI. This would make it quite challenging to achieve beneficial speed improvements with a JIT without regressing any of our primary metrics. Spending time measuring this commonly used code on warm-up can increase TTI because you have to do a little bit more work. By not including a JIT in the executable at all, then we can keep the code size down. And we can avoid using memory for the output of the JIT, the compiled machine code, which is generally 5 to 10 times larger than the underlying bytecode, which performs exactly the same tasks. We've also invested in a garbage collector, which is fast and makes efficient use of memory. Garbage collection is how you do memory management in a JavaScript application, and because memory management is such a common, allocating and releasing resources is so common, especially when you're scrolling around or doing other interactions with the app, it's really important part of your overall performance. we believe our combination of GC features is unique. Our garbage collector allocates virtual address space in chunks on demand, as needed. This avoids the need to estimate the heap size and minimizes overhead due to pre-allocating a large virtual address region during initialization. Virtual address space need not be contiguous. This avoids resource limits on 32-bit devices, where the space must be shared with Java and with other native code. This actually was an issue for us in practice and early testing. We implement a moving garbage collector. This means memory can be defragmented over time and trunks removed to the operating system to keep memory usage of the application down. And finally, we implement a generational garbage collector. This means that when we do a garbage collection, we don't have to look at all the objects in the application. We can just, most of the time, just look at a small fraction of the most recently used ones. This speeds up garbage collection and reduces pauses in your application while people are using it. In addition, with cooperation from the application, you can actually defer garbage collection completely and delay it until after TTI. This lets users interact with the application as soon as possible. Of course, solid production performance isn't enough. It's also important that developers using Hermes have a really great experience. Migrating to Hermes should be easy. Hermes is built on the React Native 0.60.1 release. First thing you'll have to do if you want to use Hermes is port your app to that version of React Native. This will be most of the work that you have to do. Then, it'll be easy to enable Hermes with just a few changes to your build.gradle file. This slide shows the most important additions in bold. And then you can easily choose to disable Hermes again if you want to try it both ways. The React Native documentation gives more complete instructions on how to migrate your apps. I'll leave a URL up at the end of the talk so that you can write that down. Or take a picture of it, or whatever. One of the main developer benefits that everybody loves about using React Native is iteration speed. You all really appreciate editing code and being able to really quickly see how it affects your application. Pre-compilation at the core of Hermes is a production win, but it would slow down the iteration speed if used in your edit, refresh, debug loop. Instead, Hermes generates bytecode lazily on device, skipping some expensive optimizations. This preserves the fast iteration speed that React Native developers are used to without impacting production performance. Hermes targets the ES6 JavaScript specification, including features such as symbols, iterators, destructuring assignment, arrow functions, libraries such as map and set, and a bunch of other stuff. We have chosen to omit some language features, such as proxies and local eval, which don't appear to be commonly used in React Native applications. We base this based on our own applications and reviewing those and seeing what language features they use. There's a complete list in the documentation of unsupported features. If you find that we actually omitted any features that your apps use, please let us know. React Native apps using Hermes also include support for the Chrome Remote Debugging Protocol. This is different from the debug.js remotely feature that you might be used to today. This runs the JavaScript in your browser. Instead, with Hermes, Chrome connects directly to the JavaScript engine running inside your application on your simulator or device. This means you can run the same engine with or without the debugger, and synchronous bridge calls can now be supported, which helps with newer work coming down the pipe like Fabric. Because you're always using Hermes on the device, you can avoid subtle bugs that might occur due to differences in your development and build environments. In the future, we also look forward to implementing support for VS Code to enable the broadest range of developer tools that React Native developers want to use, and time and memory profiling tools to make it easier to understand and improve application behavior. We're excited to build the community of Hermes users and developers. Please try out Hermes. We think you'll like it. We welcome issues and PRs on GitHub and security issues reported through Facebook's White Hat program. We're also interested to hear about new use cases for mobile-optimized JavaScript engine beyond React Native. Here are some links to the GitHub repo on Facebook, the React Native integration, and that URL got truncated, so go there and you can click to Hermes. sorry about that. and our white hat program, where you can submit security issues if you find any. Thanks for listening, and I hope you have a good time in using Hermes. Thank you.